जय श्री रंगनाथ जी फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट एपिसोड अबाउट श्रीरंगम टेंपल हिस्ट्री एंड स्थलपुराण टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी वन इनक्रेडिबल स्टोरी अबाउट वन ऑफ द आर्टवर्क्स देयर आर 12 आर्टवर्क्स आउट ऑफ व्हिच वन इज कॉल्ड तिरुप्पाना आर्टवर्क ओके दीस आर्टवर्क्स आर द स्टांच डिवोटीज ऑफ विष्णु भगवान हु वेंट ऑन टू प्रोपगेट वैष्णविज्म and devotion to Lord Vishnu and Sanatana Dharma. Many of them were not Brahmins in that. In fact, hardly one Arvar is a Brahmin. You know, others were non-Brahmins, really. You know, so we will do separate episode for it. That's why we recommend you, please, you know, before going further, make sure you like our Facebook page. Very important, you know, so that you know what is happening. And also, subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure to click the bell to get the notification for you. And also send a WhatsApp message to +1 647 964 4790 to get our one dharmic message every day. So that you can just stay connected with your roots right from your mobile phone, no matter which part of the world you live in. Okay? It's incredible. Today we are going to see Tiruppana Arvar and his connection to Srirangam temple. See, discrimination has been there in time to time basis, and our gurus and God himself has stepped in to correct these things, correct these errors at various times. And Tiruppana Arvar story is one among them, and you will love it. We will recommend you not only to watch it with You watch it with your family, make sure to share it with the children, and also share it with all your friends, family members, everybody. Because it's a very important story to know about Sanatana Dharma. See, in those days, when in Srirangam, it was told that there are four Varnas, right? You know that. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaisika, and Sudra. The Sudras were not allowed to step inside Srirangam city because it's a holy city. So the vested interest put a rule that they cannot come inside Srirangam. That's fine. But Tiruppana Arvar was a Sudra. He used to sing psalms. He was a devotee of Ranganatha. His desire was Ranganatha, seeing Ranganatha all the time. Tiruppana Arvar always was singing in devotion of Ranganatha. But see, he cannot go there to Srirangam. He cannot step inside Srirangam because he was one Atvannam and then, as per the rules of the day, he always longed to see Ranganatha. But on the other hand, Ranganatha, the god, never discriminated anybody, folks. This is what we have to understand. Ranganatha used to come and sit wherever Tiruppana Arvar was singing. This is the fact. Okay? Where you will hear this from Ranganatha himself later. One day in the early morning, the pujari comes there. The Tiruppana Arvar was sitting and it was a Brahma Muhurt. He was sitting and singing in devotion of Bhagwan Ranganatha. And he was so immersed in the psalms. He couldn't hear anything, he couldn't see anything, nothing. Okay, he already had a little bit of seeing things, issues also. And guess what? The Archaka who came to Kaveri River in the morning, they came to carry the water, to take the water and carry it to do Abhishekam to Bhagavan Ranganatha. He saw this man sitting there and seeing who is not supposed to enter Srirangam. So he says, shh, move. But Tiruppana Arvar was so immersed, he was not an Arvar yet. He was not a designated Arvar yet. Okay? He was nobody. So he was there standing and singing and he couldn't hear anything. Okay? Because he was so immersed. So this Archaka who came there, this Bhatta, he takes a stone and throws at him. And guess what? He starts bleeding. Then only he realized his mistake, that he is in the area blocking the way of the Archaka, the Bhatta. So he apologized and he was so afraid and had a guilt on himself. He ran away and hid in his neighborhood. You know, the butler, he came and took the water and he went in and went into the temple and saw, he was shocked to see Bhagavan Ranganatha was bleeding. Can you believe that? Bhagavan Ranganatha was bleeding. The butler got very shaken. He folded his hands and asked Bhagavan, "Hey Bhagavan, what happened to you? Who made this to you?" So Bhagavan Ranganatha said, "You know what? I was there in the banks of the river Kaveri, listening to the beautiful devotional songs from one of my very dear devotee, and somebody threw a stone at him. You see, the stone never hit my devotee, but it hit on me. Okay? Because I was on his feet listening to the beautiful songs that he was singing." And the priest realized the mistake. He apologized to Bhagavan Ranganatha. He said, "No question of apologies. You bring that man here. You know, you bring that man here. Then I will talk to anybody, see anybody. Otherwise, he is my devotee who has been hurt and nothing doing for me," he said. Then all the pujaris in the temple, they ran to the other side where Tirupanaruvar and their families were living. They ran and searched, and this man was so afraid because in his mind he made a guilt of stepping into the territory of Srirangam, that too on the way of the Archaka, the priest, while he was carrying the water. So he thought these people are coming there to punish him. So he hid himself in fear. Then these pujaris, they requested everybody, "Please," and they requested loudly for him to come out. And they said, "Bhagavan will not give darshan to anybody. Bhagavan will not accept any puja till you come there. Please come on over," they requested. Then slowly Tirupanaruvar appeared out. He was still shivering in fear, not knowing what is happening. But he had the faith on Bhagavan Ranganatha. So he came out, and these pujaris said, "You have to come to the temple because this is the honor of Bhagavan for you to come there." He said, "Till you have darshan, nobody else will." Can you believe this, folks? Discrimination is for you and me and normal human being and not for the God. Our God has been always a good God. You have to keep that in mind. Okay? And guess what? He was shivering. So he said, "I cannot put my feet into Srirangam. That is sin for me. As per the rule, I won't come. Please forgive me," said Tirupanaruvar. So these archakas, they said, "Your feet won't touch Srirangam, but you will go to the Lord," they said. And they carried him on the shoulder. This is the person who was not allowed, who was discriminated from entering into Srirangam. His only dream was to see the lovely eyes, lotus eyes of Bhagavan Ranganatha, and the fat, his lips, and his broad shoulders, and his blessings. Feel the blessings of Ranganatha, who is facing the south, looking at Sri Lanka. As per the promise given to the Rakshas Raj, Ravan's brother, Vibhishanarva. Now, these pujaris are carrying him on the shoulder and taking him to the temple. And here he is in front of Bhagavan Ranganatha himself. Folks, this cannot get any more better. And there standing in front of Bhagavan Ranganatha, Tirupanaruvar sings 10 pasurams. This is the only temple where hundreds of pasurams, hundreds of devotional songs have been sung by Aruvars. Never it happened. You will go to a temple where you have one or two poems that was written by one or two Arvas or three Arvas. Here, 10 of Arvas, written hundreds of poems on Bhagavan Raghunatha. That is one of the reasons why this is the number one Divya Kshetrams of out of all 108. Bhuloka Vaikuntham. And guess what? Tirumanarvar sings 10 poems, 10 songs on the name of Ranganatha. And he was emotional. Nothing else he wanted in life. He wanted to have darshan of Ranganatha. Ranganatha was always next to him. He was sitting on his feet, listening to his songs always. But Tirumanarvar didn't know that. You see, he was there for the very first time. And he was so emotional. Then after singing the 10 songs, he goes close to the deity of Ranganatha. He goes close to Ranganatha and guess what? And merges with the god once for all. This is the story of Tirupanarvar. Friends, you know what? This shows us a couple of facts. In Srirangam temple, the god talks. This is a history, folks. We are not talking about some kind of hypothetical story. This is a history that happened here. And the poem written by Tirumanarvar being chanted on a daily basis by thousands and thousands and thousands of devotees as part of the Dravida Vedam. Can you believe that? The person who was told not to step into Srirangam became an Arvar. The person who was told not to step into Srirangam and we ever have a darshan of Ranganatha became the leading force on whose feet others fall for blessings. This is the story of Tirupanarvar, which says when you have devotion, you can elevate yourself from anywhere to anywhere. No questions about it. This also gives you one more reason why we are very thankful that you are watching this video about the Srirangam temple and its history and Stala Puran. But you should come there once in a lifetime at least and stay for some days if you can to completely go through this temple and understand that temple, because here the god here is a talking god. You will see era after era after era the god talking and blessing. Here in Srirangam, Ranganathji and Ranganayaki Thaya, mother gods, are blessing the devotees abundantly. And we feel and we wish you, your family and your loved ones shall be blessed abundantly and exceedingly with all wealth, prosperity, happiness and peace. Stay connected with our one dharmic message every day by sending a WhatsApp. Looking forward to talk to you very soon. Jai Sri Ranganathji.